KiCad is such an incredible software which is completely free to use. But people who are just getting started might get overwhelmed by the amount of options and settings it has to offer. So learning each tool without real-world examples would be very difficult. Also, a little boring. So in this video, we'll select an interesting project and build a circuit diagram using the schematic editor in KiCad. This is the project that we are going to work with. It's a digital Diya, which can react to light and also to sound and act almost like a real Diya. If you're interested in this project, I'll drop a link in the description where you can find more information about this project. To start, I've created a new KiCad project and opened the schematic editor. From the previous video, you should be familiar with these editor tools and also how to navigate around KiCad schematic editor. First, let me show the circuit that we are going to build using the schematic editor. This is the complete circuit of the Diya. If you're wondering how I build this, that will be a topic for another video. Here you can see I have one 80 tiny microcontroller, a few resistor and few other components. So we'll start with placing those components on the drawing sheet first. To get those components, you can either use the shortcut A or you can click on this button over here. This will bring up the components search menu and we'll search and add the components that we need. Personally, I love the way they have arranged all the components and how you can search for it. For example, if you need a resistor, all you have to do is just type R. And for a capacitor, you just have to type C. And similarly, for many basic and standard components, you just have to use one key search. For this particular circuit, we'll start with the resistor. So I'll start with R and click OK. Now you can see the symbol follows the cursor and once you do a left click, the component is placed on the document. Hi, sorry for the interruption. Just a quick note, I might have forgotten to mention in the previous video, you can also look at the bottom status bar to know which tool you have currently selected and you can use escape key to go back to the default selection. Since the currently selected tool is add symbol, click again and add another resistor. But before placing, what if I want the orientation to be different? In that case, I can use the letter R for rotation. This will rotate the symbol but won't be placed on the document until you do a left click. Now to go out of the tool, you can press the escape key. For my taste, the resistor look a little far from each other. What if I want to move them very close to each other? You can hover your cursor over the symbol and press M. Now, you can move around the symbol as well as simultaneously, you can change the orientation of the resistor by pressing the letter R to rotate. Once you are satisfied with the placement, you can just do a left click. Now, let me quickly place all the remaining components on the document. You can see the 80985 pinout looks a bit odd and doesn't match the standard convention for numbering from left to right. This is to optimize the symbol on the circuit diagram to make it look neat. Usually, the positive power symbol is placed on the top and the ground is placed at the bottom. And in some cases, they would also group few pins together for easier understanding. If you noticed, I haven't placed the symbols for the power and ground yet because you can access this in multiple ways. You can either use the add symbol and search for the ground, or you can use the next button on the list, add power symbol, to search power symbols specifically. And now for some reason, if you like to delete any of the components, you can just hover over them and press the delete key, or you can use the delete clicked items tool and click on the item that you want to delete. Now before connecting all these components together, there is one crucial thing that I'm missing. That's the value to the symbols. Currently they are just set with their default values R. We can change this value just by hovering over the symbol and by pressing the letter V. And here you can enter the value of the component. And if you look a little down, you have few more additional options to customize the way they look. But for now, I'll just keep them to default. Seems like only the single R value changed. What about the R and the question mark? These extra values are called designators and they are currently mentioned with question mark because I have turned off the automatic annotation. Once we complete the circuit, I'll show you how to automatically number everything together at once. Now we have all the components on the document and if you like the placement, we can start with connecting the wires together. You can either click on the button below the power symbol or you can use the shortcut W. This will bring up the wire tool. I can make the connection just by clicking on one pin and then clicking on the pin of the other symbol. If you like to control the way the wire is connected to your component, you can use the left click while moving to the next component. And if you remember from previous videos, we can use these tools to make varieties of connections. There are also ways you can change the appearances of these wires that connects the symbols. Now go back to the selection tool by pressing escape and hovering over the wire, press the letter E. So this should give you the width of the wire, also the color of the wire that you like to set. But personally, I like the default settings KiCad provides. So I'll just revert back to the previous color. Either you can use the undo button or by just pressing Ctrl Z. Now let me go quickly arrange these components and connect them all together. Let me be honest, this is one of the ugliest circuits I have ever done. It's just I wanted to use the same tools that I showed you in this video to make the entire circuit. And this should be good enough sometimes if you don't care about people looking at your circuit and you're just doing for your reference. But this is not good enough if you want to build a PCB or share this circuit to someone. But so far, it's a very good progress. And in the next video, we'll discuss some more tools on this toolbar and also make sure the circuit is looking good overall. Until then, if you have any questions regarding this topic we discussed in this video or any other questions related to PCB, you can always reach out to me at PCBCupid Q&A. And if you like watching this kind of content, make sure to subscribe to this channel and also share with people who might be interested in this kind of videos. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.